Pivot tables also allow you to group certain items together. There are three main ways of grouping, but let's first look at the manual grouping method. In this pivot table, you'll notice that we've got five separate items here. And let's say we'd like these three to be grouped. The process is very simple. In the pivot, you highlight the areas you want grouped, you right click, and you'll see down here there's something called group. When I push group, what it does, it creates a new row label, calls it group 1, and that item is now grouped together. Just looking at your field list here, if you go right to the bottom, you'll also notice it's created another row label here, which you can now drag into wherever you want to go. If you need to, you can change this name. So for example, these might be cell companies, and the pivot table will remember this name. So for example, if I come here and remove this row label, you'll see we're back where we started. I come back in here, put it down, put it back in, and you'll see it's remembered the grouping name. You can group many items. To ungroup, it's as simple as you right click, you go ungroup, and you'll see the grouping is lost and the row label is gone. Let's now change the pivot table so that the destination networks are over here. Get rid of months and I put the date in over here. So now what we have is all the dates in the row labels, and we now want to do some grouping. Excel is very clever in the sense that if it identifies in the row label that there are dates, when you attempt to group it, it brings up its own specialized little dialog box. But before we get into that, I just want to show you a common problem with pivot tables. I'm just going to cancel it, go into PhoneBill, and I'm just going to delete this one item, one single date out of a whole list of dates. Go back here, I'm going to just refresh this. Okay. If I try and now right click and say group, notice it says it cannot group the selection. For whatever reason, because of this one single cell which doesn't have a similar date, Excel has decided that it cannot understand what it must do with this cell, and therefore the rest of the cells cannot be grouped. So you have to be careful. If you ever do this, you try to do a grouping and it doesn't work, you need to go look in the data and look for cells that are blank or have a number in or a word in. This commonly happens when right at the bottom, instead of doing the pivot table up to that row, perhaps you add a few more rows in, and as a result Excel sees the blanks. So just to get it back, just got to fill that in and just refresh. Going back to the dates, we can right click and say group. Now let's investigate what we've got here. It allows you to decide whether you want to, where you want to start and end, so similar to the filter. But then you can say I want to group it by, and you can see we've got the options of by seconds, minutes, hours, days, months, quarters, years. So let's start out with months. So I've clicked on months. When I say OK, you'll see what it's done is it summarized the dates into the 3 months that it sees. To ungroup, very simple, you click, you say ungroup. Let's go back in there, group. Let's say we actually want to do it by quarters. When I click on quarters, notice both are highlighted. So if I only want quarters, I need to switch off the months. So I can click like that and I can say OK. And in this case, we only have one quarter. Let's just go back to grouping. Let's do quarters and months. When I click OK, you'll see it creates multiple row labels and basically works its way down through the groupings. I right click again and say group. Let's now switch off the quarters and the months and let's put it onto days. And notice if you activate the days function, you can actually specify the number of days. So if we want to group these dates by perhaps weeks, Let's make it, please group it in days of seven. And when I say OK, you'll see it groups it into days of seven. So in this case, from the 25th to the 31st, 1st to the 7th, etc. Again, to remove the grouping, you just go ungroup. Another interesting option is grouping numbers. So let's first get the pivot table correct. So I'm going to get rid of the dates. Let's get rid of the destination network. And in the values, we've got the sum of bill. What I'm going to do is I'm going to pull the bill through again. But this time I'm going to take it and put it into the row labels. I'm going to let go. You'll notice we've got all the numbers here. Now, this will also have the same issue explained with the dates, in the sense that if one of the cells in here is a blank or a word, it won't allow you to group. But let's just understand what we've got here. What Excel has done is taken all the bill data, found the unique numbers, and put them as row labels. So for example, you'll see it looked for the row label of 2, and it's only found one of them, so it adds up to 2. But perhaps over here, for that 6, it actually must have found 2 of them that added up to 12. So all this is a grouping or a unique listing of all the items in here, and this adds them up. This of itself is not a particularly useful report. You can see it just goes on and on and on. But by using the grouping feature, you can make it useful. So when I right click on it and I say group, because Excel sees that these are numbers, it gives us a different type of dialog box. And in this case, it's saying, okay, I'm going to start at 0 because that's what it's found is the lowest. It's going to end at 36.35, which is probably the maximum. And at the moment, it's grouping it by groups of 10. Let's just change this and say, no, let's go up to, let's say, 30. And let's group it in groups of 5. When I say OK, you'll see what it produces is a very nice report, which tells me that from 0 to 5 rand spent on the bill, those type of calls add up to 943. Calls that range from 5 to 10 rand, those add up to 574. So in this case, you can actually analyze where the majority of your calls are happening, what length of time. So you'll notice here that the 15 to 20 rand calls are at 115, but once you go over a certain point, once you get to the 20 to 25 rand calls, we seem to then spend a little bit more here. Again, to get rid of the grouping or to change the grouping, you click on group and you can make the changes. Or to get rid of it, you right click and you say ungroup, and it is gone.